ladies and gentlemen, Garry Moore.
It's been a long time since we've had a faction show on To Tell the Truth, and my wife's complaining about that. But this is our lucky day, because today our first contestant is a gentleman who won the very prestigious Coty Award for Fashions. You gals know all about that, and us guys know all about models, so we'll have fun there. And meanwhile, let's say hello to our panel right here on To Tell the Truth. Dean Rayburn. Peggy Katz. Jack Cassidy. And Kitty Carlisle. I tell you, there's something about that Jack Cassidy. Remember George Gobel's line that said, did you ever feel like the whole world was a tuxedo and you were a pair of brown shoes?
No, but I love that line.
Cassidy has a marvelous flair about him. It makes me feel like I'm stumbling.
I only had Kitty's clothes, though. Well,
anytime, Jack.
Well, gals, it's your time for the clothes. So now let's meet the man who won the Coty Award.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is John Anthony.
Number two.
My name is John Anthony.
Number three.
My name is John Anthony.
All right, let's listen to the award-winning affidavit of John Anthony as follows. I, John Anthony, am a clothes designer and the recipient of the celebrated Winnie at the 1972 Coty American Fashion Critics Awards. I was only the second designer in the 29-year history of the awards to be so honored in his first year in business. I was cited for my leadership in the revival of tailored elegance in fashion, which has inaugurated a new feeling in contemporary clothes. My high fashion designs feature both precision cut and great mobility to take a woman from 8 a.m. right through till midnight. My elegant clothes at a moderate price represent the success secret of the 70s. Later on in the program, there will be a high fashion show featuring three lovely models in a variety of John Anthony creations. Signed, John Anthony. And our journey into high fashion will begin right after we pay the piper who pays the bills. Alrighty, now remember that all three of these gentlemen across the way claim to be John Anthony, designer of elegant ladies' clothes and winner of the Coty Award. And we'll start with the slovenly Jack Cassidy.
Oh, yes, thank you, Garry. Number two, who started the layer look?
The layer look?
Mm-hmm.
A gentleman by the name of Friedman.
Friedman. Yes. Number three, do you agree with that?
No, I don't. I would say Adolfo really started it.
Well, I've always enjoyed his work. Number one?
Yves Saint Laurent.
I see. Number one, who is now the editor of Women's Wear Daily?
Number one, sir?
John Fairchild.
Thank you. Number two?
I would agree with that.
All right. Number three, who would you consider, or who is considered in the fashion world today as being the black fashion designer on the West Coast?
I would say Stephen Burroughs would be considered the major.
Mr. Anthony, number two?
I would say Burroughs, as he said, or there's another gentleman by the name of Smith, Willie Smith.
And from Jack, we go to Kitty Carlisle.
Number three, what magazine, number three, what magazine did Jan Vreeland edit?
Vogue magazine.
And number two, it says here that you make clothes that take a woman from 8 a.m. through till midnight. What happens to her after midnight? Does she turn into a pumpkin?
No. No, she doesn't turn into a pumpkin, but I think after midnight, that would be optional. Then she's on her own time.
Ah, very good answer. Number one, what is your collection cost?
It could cost from 25 to 35, $50,000.
Thank you. And number three, where did you find your backing all of a sudden, like this, out of the blue?
Most designers have business managers.
So and you found the backing.
It comes
number,
from a
thank nurse. You. Number two, what did you do before you were a fashion designer?
That was really the only thing that I did. I started in high school.
Oh, thank you. But number one, the 72 Cody Award, it says it was your first year in business. What did you do before that? Were you in business with somebody else?
No, I was just designing, working for someone.
Who was it?
It was for Mr. Buzz.
I'll never know.
Go down to Gene.
Thank you, Gary. Number three, you were the second winner to win this award in its 29-year history. Do you happen to know who the other first-year winner was?
Norman Norell, I believe you mean.
Number two, who designed your jacket?
Would you believe Pierre Cardin?
Okay, I believe anything you say. Number three, one, who's the president of Bonwit Tellers?
Bill Fine. Yeah.
And number three, do you know what Kenny Lane designs?
Sportswear, accessories and sportswear.
Number two, do you have a retail outlet in New York?
Oh, yes.
Would you tell us, I guess you wouldn't be too shy about telling us where that is or who does it?
No, of course not. However, it's a difficult situation in that we don't like to give people plugs unless we absolutely have to.
It's all right, I own the store.
I'm going to force you to give a plug here.
We've never had that trouble before.
Never in the
usually
history.
People want to come in and mention 20 things. Pam?
You don't mind too much. Number two, whom does Don Simonelli design for?
Don Simonelli designs for... It escapes me.
Number three, who designs for Molly Parnas's boutique?
I really don't know.
Thank
I'm sorry.
You. Number one, whom does Casper design for?
JL Sport, I think.
Thank you. Number two, where is your place of business located? Your showroom.
On 7th Avenue, 550 7th Avenue, on the 24th floor.
Thank you. 550 7th Avenue?
Mm-hmm.
Number three, do you know where Anne Klein is?
550.
Thank you. Number one, how much does Norman Norell charge? How much does a normal Norman Norell dress is compared to one of yours? By the way, I ordered one of your dresses. I haven't gotten it yet. It's the black one. Well, I won't go into it. How much does a Norman Norell retail for?
I think anywhere from 1,000 and up.
Right.
What?
Ain't it awful, Mabel?
Well, Miss Cash, you must have gotten a raise when the nurse...
Are you kidding? I never wore Norman Norell.
It's hard to believe you come from off-Broadway, too.
Anyhow, the bell rang, and that means that we got to quit asking questions. We have to mark our ballots. And the audience and I are going to take a look over here and try to decide between number one and number two... and number three. And as you know, we pay $50 for each wrong vote. We pay $500 if all the votes are wrong. And Jack Cassidy started the questioning. He starts the voting.
Well, I did vote for number one, Gary, based on the fact that the man did have some very solid answers, and he was not hesitant about giving them.
All righty, so we got a one, Sean.
Well, this is a tough panel to beat when it comes to fashion. You all were absolutely marvelous, but turns out Jack Cassidy knows as much about fashion as we do. And number one, you, John Fairchild, Saint Laurent, Bill Fine. And number three said Kenny Lane made sportswear. He makes costume jewelry. I voted for number one.
Pair one, Sean. And we got Gene.
Yeah, we tripped up number three on Kenny Lane. And also number two and three both said 550 Fifth Avenue, which happens to be a vacant lot.
I know, I just bought it.
So, therefore, I voted for number one, and because he said Bill Fine of Bonwits with such authority.
All right, 3-1s, and I just saw it was just that one stroke vote of yours.
Well, Kate. Although I'm known as Rita Rags in television, I certainly feel fashion when I see it. Number one.
Alrighty, this is the way it goes. The votes are all in. Will the real John Anthony please stand up? Drat! Gary Guys, what can I say? It's a nice try. Number two, what is your real name, please, and what do you do?
My real name is George Taylor. I'm a singer, pianist, and actor, and I am currently appearing at the Camelot Restaurant at 73rd and 3rd here in Manhattan.
Hey, good luck. And number three, tell us about you.
My name is Gerald Thornton, and I'm vice president of John Rockwell and Associates, an advertising agency in New York.
Oh, yeah. Well, now I know that all you ladies out there, and certainly Kitty and Peggy in here, will be delighted to know that John Anthony has prepared a miniature fashion show, especially for us. And he has furnished the models to demonstrate exactly why he won the Coty Award. So, John Anthony, if you will describe for the ladies what it is that the girls are wearing, us ignorant men folk will sit here and drool at the ladies.
Natasha is wearing a dark brown wrap coat, trimmed with a lavish lynx shawl collar and cuffs. To complete the ensemble, she wears a matching dark brown jersey flared dress. Thank you, Tasha. Brown is one of my favorite colors. This time, Kathy wears a brown sequined pantsuit, the classic cardigan jacket, tops a brown chiffon blouse that ties at the neck with a bow. The pants are straight and wide, covered with glitter. Thank you, Kathy. This is one of my favorite designs. Pat wears a long white wool coat bordered in white fox. She takes off the coat to reveal a silk jersey backless dinner dress. Simple in design, but elegant. Thank you, Pat. And And that concludes our fashion show.
Well, John Anthony, it was just great. One big drool from one end to the other. Thank you, and thank you, gentlemen, however unlucky you were. Good having you with us here on the television. Now, Kitty. Kitty, you seem to think that last coat was pretty elegant,
I felt that the coat was really me, but I wasn't sure about the dress.
Well, the dress is mine.
I like what he was wearing.
What? Yeah. Pity smart.
Yes.
But I tell you, talk about elegance. You think you've heard about elegance. Our next guest traveled over 11,000 miles just to kill some cockroaches. Now, that's class. That's
you can
elegant.
Come to my house.
So don't touch a little dial down there for a couple of minutes, because you're going to hear about this. Now let's say hello to our well-traveled exterminator.
Number one, what is your name, please?
My name is Glenn Burkhalter.
Number two.
My name is Glenn Burkhalter.
Number three.
My name is Glenn Burkhalter.
And here is the buggy biography of Glenn Burkhalter. It says, I, Glenn Burkhalter, made an 11,000-mile round-trip service call to stamp out cockroaches. As an entomologist and director of training with the Orkin Pest Control Division of Rollins Incorporated, I was responding to a plea from the U.S. Embassy in Moscow to bring their roach infestations under control. Advice by telephone appeared impractical, so off I went to Moscow. From a stainless steel spray can, I attacked the little germ-carrying devils with professional intensity, saving my big gun for last, a microgen mist applicator that spewed a thick, smoky, lethal mist. Bidding the roach residue a fond adieu, I then taught Soviet employees how to follow up my work. Oh, and by the way, although during my stay in Moscow, I spotted Oriental roaches and German roaches, there was not one single Russian roach to be found. Signed, Glenn Burkhalter.
Number four.
And we'll start the questioning with a man who knows the difference between etymology and entomology, Mr. Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gary. Number three, how do you tell the difference between a Russian and a German roach? By the funny way they talk, maybe? How do you do that?
No, actually, there is no such thing as a Russian roach. There are roaches which are actually Oriental roaches in East Germany that the East Germans call Russian roaches.
Okay.
But there's no such thing as a Russian roach.
Number two, can you name one of the chlorinated hydrocarbons, please?
Yes, I would say chlordane.
Yes, and number one, do you know what chlordane is used for?
Yes, it's to cleanse the infestations that do drop on the roaches.
Thank you. Number three, are roaches scavengers?
Yes, they'll eat anything.
Yeah. Oh, my.
Number two, what substance did you use in Russia? What was that stuff that you sprayed through? What is a microgen?
A microgen is a new concept in fogging. It's used to put out a mist.
That's what I thought.
All right. I'm sure you did. Let's go to Peggy.
Now, number one, where did you gather your experience in roach killing? I mean, how did you start out in that line of work?
Well, I went to the University of Delaware.
Was it very roach infested there?
No, not the university, but I got my degree in agricultural farming and science control.
Oh, and so you went from there to cockroaches. Now, number three, is there an American cockroach?
Yes, ma'am, there is.
And so there's Russian, there's German, Oriental, and American cockroaches.
That's correct.
You want to meet some, I can fix you up. Now, number two, how do you see them? Do you go in the middle of the night and turn on the light and there they are? Because that's the way I always see them.
Well, if you have an infestation, that certainly would be one way.
Yeah, now, number two, do you sell your stuff commercially? This is nothing personal, folks. I mean, do you sell it commercially?
No, we do not. We provide a service commercially.
I see. Now, number three, it says germ carrying. What kind of germs do they carry? That's a gloomy outlook.
I was just thinking Peggy lives in one of the fanciest apartment houses in New York, and they're going to be glad for this publicity, Peggy. I'll be glad to hear when you get your eviction notice. Let's go to Jack Cassidy, please.
Gary, unfortunately, I have to disqualify myself.
Oh,
no. You know the roaches?
No, I don't know the roaches.
Oh, sure. But for this to get around all over the country.
Well, she gets pesty sometimes, too, you know. No, actually, Mr. Burkholder and I did a beat the clock together. Mr. Burkholder was once on the panel of What's My Line? And I didn't guess him there either, but today I have an advantage.
Well, in any event, you have to disqualify, and a disqualification, of course, unfortunately, counts for a wrong vote. And that you go to Kitty.
Well, I want to stand up for Peggy, because it's quite true that in New York City, it's very difficult to have any kind of an apartment without a roach. Very difficult. Number three, and you don't always have to go into the kitchen late at night and turn on the light to see him either. Number three, your smoky lethal mist, is that also lethal for people?
No, it's not. It's not effective on people at all.
I see. Number one, you say that you were an agricultural something or other. Do you believe that DDT is bad for people and crops, or is it worth the amount of food that one is able to grow?
No, it's bad to use on crop.
Thank you. Number two, are there any roaches who don't carry germs at all, like Peggy's or my one?
I would think that all roaches could carry disease germs.
Number three, what kind of disease?
I can see Kitty's got this one roach and she walks him on Park Avenue. It is time now, friends, for us to mark our little ballots. And we mark them as follows. We mark them for number one, or for number two, or for number three. And if everybody has made their number, Gene, we'll start with you, my friend.
Yes, sir. Number three said roaches are scavengers. It's my understanding they are not. And number one really didn't know what chlordane was used for. And number two very quickly identified the chlorinated hydrocarbons, so he got my vote.
Tough question. And we got a two there, Peg.
Well, I just love the name of that perfume, Smoky Lethal Mist. It sounds so sexy.
Sounds like a stripper.
Kitty, I really don't like this to do this to you, but I don't have any cockroaches, number one.
I voted for number six, Carrie.
Ah,
You disqualify. We got a one, a two, a one, a disqualification, and Kitty.
That's all right. My one cockroach has just gone to visit you. I voted for number one because his pants look like they're slightly worn at the knee. No offense, man. Well, if you let me explain. Well, because where do you find cockroaches on the floor? And he's had to look for them in corners, and he's had to get down on his hands and knees.
Keep talking.
His pants are slightly worn at the knees.
Quick, what's in the needle?
Sheesh, what a dingbat. All right, everybody's voted. Let's see how we turn out here. At this point, will the real Glenn Burkhalter please stand up? Yo, it's the number two. Nice shot, gentlemen. Number one, you did a good job. What's your real name? What do you do?
My name is Frank McNally, and I sell commercial television time.
Oh, hey. Hate it. Number three, the chlorodynane or whatever that was, did you in? What's your real name? What do you do?
My name is Hans Horning. I work for a bank here in New York City.
Well, Mr. Burkhalter, no more time. The best I can say to you is happy hunting. Take care, gentlemen. Thank you very much. What, 1 second left? I don't even have time to say.
Our central characters today will receive Brock's 14 karat gold filled writing instruments, recognized and appreciated for their lasting value. Brock, the name quality made famous. Promotional consideration provided by Best Western Motels, the nation's largest chain of 1,200 fine owner operated motels in 900 cities coast to coast.
If Bob were an animal, he'd be a stallion. Sarah thinks more like a chicken, and Linda, well, Linda thinks... Liposuction. Sure, Sally's had it. Her ex knows because it was his idea. Her husband's gonna know because it was his credit card. Teresa thinks its name is Mr. Happy. Christy thinks he plays with it in the park. The truth is, Mark doesn't even own a dog. All new, three's a crowd. Find out who knows you best tonight at 9:30 Eastern, 6:30 Pacific.